Andrew and Jonah are nominated for eviction, but who will win the golden power veto? Find out now on Big Brother Cheesecake 6 Hockey Sticks. Hello, I'm Andrew Shevsek-Moonves. Welcome to Big Brother Cheesecake 6 Hockey Sticks. It's day 47 inside the Big Brother Cheesecake house, and this week Karen was or is the head of household. She nominated Andrew and Jonah for eviction, but who will win the golden power veto? We'll find out shortly. But first, sorry this episode is super late today, but I got back late this weekend. I was in Buffalo with Kat from season 4 and 5 yesterday. First cross-border shopping trip to Buffalo in 591 days since March 1st, 2020. We both got the PCR test, tested negative. We both had the swab put up our nose. Found it kind of a turn-on, but and we paid $95 for it each. You think anybody at the border would have asked us for it? No! They didn't even ask if we were vaccinated or not. We got to the border. Where are you going? Buffalo. What purpose? Shopping and dinner. Okay, bye. Like, oh. It's just frustrating when the government puts out all these rules. You abide by the rules and pay $95 to get your nose jabbed and find out that you're negative, and then nobody even asks you. And it, like, it's just so annoying. But yeah, we went to the Olive Garden. It was absolute sex, as always. Although they got rid of the stuffed mushrooms. Very disappointing. Their stuffed mushrooms were amazing. We went to Dunkin' Donuts, which is my absolute fave. Their iced coffee is just out of this world. And where else did we go? We got some clothes at my favorite retail store for clothes is Express, which went under in Canada about 4 years ago now. And I just go to the US now for it. I don't know. It's just the sizes are right, and it's my style. Nah. Yeah, and that's pretty much about it. And of course, then we went to Wegmans and we got all of our favorite cereals that you can't get in Canada, like Fruit Loops with marshmallows and Frosted Flakes with marshmallows and Cheerios with marshmallows. And I know what you're going to say. You're going to say, why don't you buy a pack of those mini marshmallows and put them in the cereal and then it's the same thing? No. For some reason, putting standard marshmallows in your cereal, it doesn't actually do anything. The marshmallows that they use in the cereal themselves, like that Kellogg's does, it has that sort of like crunch factor. So, And there's just something about Kat screaming slow down when you're driving 140 in a 100 zone. That's just, I don't know, it's exhilarating. So it was a very fun day. Okay, so before we get to the results of the NHL-a-thon, which, is a, I would say, a pretty heavily luck-based comp, but it's also kind of fun. I mean, Jonah said it's the first time he ever cared about professional sports, so good for him. Before we get to that, I want to get to Karen's head of household bedroom. Oh my god, I'm Karen, I'm the head of household, this is so exciting. Hi everyone, let's all go upstairs to my head of household bedroom. Okay, here we go. Is everybody here? Where's Rhonda? Rhonda, hurry up! Come on, move it! No pain, no gain. No, before you're dead. Okay, well, I think she's coming. Okay, here we go. Oh my god, I got two Uncle Tetsu's cheesecakes. Wow, I got two sets of Lindor chocolates. OMG. Wow, some Buffalo freebies from Andrew. Oh my god, peppermint Kit Kat and gingerbread Kit Kat. Oh, unbelievable. Oh, white chocolate Reese's. That's amazing too. Oh wow, I absolutely love all this selection. Oh wow, and I got a CD. It's Hanson Bop. I love that song. Oh, and I also got BTS. Oh my god, the BTS album. It is signed. Oh my god, who's it signed by? Oh, Andrew Shevsek-Moonves. What a narcissist. Anyway, oh my god, the video is coming down. I'm so excited to watch this video.
Hey Karen, congratulations on your HOH I know this is your second one. Good job. I have a few guests who also wanted to congratulate you as well. The first one is Ryland. He was also in season 3 and All-Stars. He did very well. And I actually have one more guest for you that is dying to wish you congratulations. And I will bring them in right now. Our special guest.
Hello, Karen. Congratulations. I heard that you were a fan of me on Robinson Podcast. So Jonathan invited me to give you an extra special congratulations for your second Head of Household win. So I think that is amazing. I'm super proud of you. And from me and everybody at Robinson Podcast, congratulations.
Kick some butt, Karen. We'll see you later.
Kick some butt!
OMG, it is Chantel, winner of Big Brother Cheesecake 3 and runner-up in season 5, and Jonathan, who also played, oh my god, so excited to see that. I love them. So thank you guys. Okay, everybody else, I'm gonna make some tea now. I'm gonna make chamomile tea, so if you're interested, you can stay. But you need to have hot tea for me in order for me to give you hot tea. Okay, bye everyone. So Jonathan has cast a vote in alumni votes. And so I figured he wasn't just gonna, like, when I asked him, because I've struggled getting videos for Karen, because the person who I had planned for her chickened out or ghosted me. So I asked Jonathan, he said yes. And when I got the video, I was like, okay, like, this is a cool video. And I was expecting, when he said there's a special guest, I was expecting either somebody from Endure or JoJo. And when I saw Chantel, I was like, wow. So thank you, Chantel. Thank you, Jonathan. We definitely had a bumpy end to All Stars. But you know, I've moved on. I hope you've all moved on, and we've all apologized to each other. And you know, I'm thankful that Chantel appeared in the video. I know that some of the alumni watched that video and are probably throwing up, but that's on them, not on me. Oh, and Ryland is still so cute. And Jonathan, you'll be happy to know that I no longer have a crush on you, so that's probably for the best. Okay, so now let's get to the results of the Big Brother NHL-a-thon. So this is a very important veto because... and I forgot to mention, I did say in the group chat, expect the unexpected. Nobody seems to have given a shit, but you'll be sorry. This was a very interesting competition because Andrew and Jonah are on the block, and a lot of people were already tabulating votes, but assuming the nominations would stay. And if one of them comes off, when you include the potential of Brooke Sapphire veto, Amy's Ruby veto, Caitlyn's Pooh Brown veto, Andrew's Amethyst veto getting in the mix, this week is a huge question mark, and Corey, as the fast forward holder, and Karen as head of household, are lucky to be safe, because it's the conversations. I was up till 2 a.m. last night just reading group chats, because it was just wild. So anyway, finishing in 6th place with 21 points is Corey. Finishing in 5th place with 27 points, Karen. A tie for 3rd with 31 points is Jonah and Steven. It should be noted Jonah would have likely beaten Steven because he thought New York Rangers were playing Columbus when it was actually Colorado, or vice versa. It was actually Columbus, and I mistakenly said Colorado. So Jonah might have put Colorado to win there. New York to win there. But it doesn't matter. It didn't affect the results. So we're down to Andrew and Brooke. Andrew the nominee, Brooke the Sapphire veto holder. One of them scored 39 points. The other scored 34 points. Here is the spreadsheet of results. Congratulations, Andrew. You have won the Golden Power of Veto. And at the time of this recording, you've already told me what you're going to do. But Karen, I need the name of a replacement nominee by 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time tonight. And yeah, so congratulations, Andrew. You have clinched a spot in jury along with Corey and Karen. So who will Karen nominate in Andrew's place? Find out tomorrow in the Golden Power Veto ceremony. Tuesday, the final two nominees play their case, and we find out what the unexpected is. And it's a big one. And Wednesday is the next live eviction and head of household competition where another house guest will be evicted from the Big Brother Cheesecake Sixth House. Be the last house guest to fail to clinch a spot in the playoffs, lose their shot at the $600 cash prize, and we will find out the identity of the final nine. I'm Andrew Shevcik-Mubez. Take care and remember, if you want to win the game, you had better be ready to adapt.